Bristol Community College Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 131, Elements of College Mathematics, Section 1.1, Problem 19. This is question number 19 from Section 1.1. It says the relationship between degrees Celsius and degrees Fahrenheit for measuring temperature is linear. Find an equation relating degrees Celsius and degrees Fahrenheit if 0 degrees Celsius corresponds to 32 degrees Fahrenheit and 100 degrees Celsius corresponds to 212 degrees Fahrenheit. Use your equation to find the Celsius measure of 68 degrees Fahrenheit. So this is another question where we have to find a linear equation. So I know that I'm going to have to fill in the formula for a linear equation, which is y minus y1 equals m times x minus x1. Now, when we fill this in, some parts of this formula stay as they are, and some parts have to have a number value. The parts that need a number value are y1, m, and x1. So I underline the parts that need to have a number value. And to fill this in, we're either going to need to know the coordinates of 2 points or 1 point and the slope. Now, when you read this line, keeping in mind that you're looking for 2 points or a point and a slope, what you're getting is you have the coordinates of 2 points, and the 2 points are the 0 degrees Celsius corresponds to 32 degrees Fahrenheit, that's 1 point, and 100 degrees Celsius corresponds to 212 degrees Fahrenheit. That's the other point. So these are x, y coordinates. So 0 degrees Celsius corresponds to 32 degrees Fahrenheit. So that's an x and y coordinate of 1 point. And this happens to be the freezing temperatures of water. Most of you probably recognize those numbers. And the other point comes from the sentence where it says 100 degrees Celsius corresponds to 212 degrees Fahrenheit. And again, you might recognize that as the boiling point. So 100, 212 gives me the coordinates of a second point. Now I have all the information I need to fill in my formula for the equation of a line. Now you may notice that I put the Celsius measure first, or in the x position, and the Fahrenheit measure second, or in other words, in the y position. And the reason I do that is it's just the way that it's given in the problem. The problem mentions the Celsius temperature first, I put it first, and they mention the Fahrenheit temperature second, so I put Fahrenheit second. As long as you do it consistently, you really could do it either way and get the same answer at the end of the problem. So I could have made it 32, 0 and 212, 100. And when all the in-between steps would look different, but the final answer in the end, when I find the value of 68 degrees Fahrenheit, it's going to come out the same. I did it this way just because it's listed this way in the problem, with the Celsius first and then the Fahrenheit. So the 0, 32 is my first point, so I will consider its x coordinate to be x1 and its y coordinate to be y1. And the 100, 212 is the second point, so its x coordinate I will label as x2, and its y coordinate I will label as y2. And that's going to give me most of what I need to fill in the formula for the equation of a line. As I look at that formula, I can see one of the pieces I'm going to need a number value for is m, or slope. So before I start filling this in, off to the side here, I'll figure out what the m is. So the formula for m, or formula for slope, is y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. And then I'll fill that in, which is easy enough to do because I labeled the x and y coordinates of my point 1 and point 2. So m equals, in the numerator of my formula, y2 is 212. Then the formula tells me I have a minus. Then y1 is 32. And then in the denominator, I have x2 minus x1. The value of x2 is 100 minus the value of x1 is 0. And I can do the math. M equals, in the numerator, 212 minus 32 is 180. And in the denominator, 100 minus 0 is just 100. So you can divide that out and do 180 divided by 100 equals, and I can see it's 1.8. Or you could write the fractional equivalent if you like, which is 9/5. 1.8 is probably good, easy to deal with. So now that I know what the slope is, let me go back to the formula for the equation of a line, which is y minus y1 equals m times x minus x1, and fill in the parts that need a number value. So as we start, y minus y1. y1 has an underline, so the number value I have to put in is 32. Equals, the next piece of the formula is m. It has a number line also. The value for m, I calculate it off to the side here, is 1.8. And then parentheses, x minus x1. X1 has an underline, so it needs a number value. The number value for x1 will be 0. Close the parentheses. Now that is the answer. I can simplify it fairly easily. First of all, the x minus 0, I can really just write as x. So the y minus 32 equals 1.8x. I don't really need the minus 0. And at this point, I don't really have to, but I can just bring the 32 from the left over to the right. Just add 32 to both sides. It'll cancel on the left and show up on the right, and I'll have y equals 1.8x plus 32. And that'll put it in y equals mx plus b form, which I don't really need to know to find the equivalent of 68 degrees Fahrenheit, but I might as well. So now the last part of the problem says take the linear equation relating degrees Celsius to degrees Fahrenheit and use that equation to find the Celsius temperature for 68 degrees Fahrenheit. So what I'll have to do is put in a 68 into the formula and solve for the other variable. Now the question is, do I put in the 68 for y or do I put in the 68 for x? And it makes a difference. So now 68 is in Fahrenheit, it says so in the question. So now as I look at the way I wrote the coordinates of the points, it's the y value that lines up with the Fahrenheit measurement. So the 68 in the question has to be put in for y. So y equals 1.8x plus 32 becomes 68 equals 1.8x plus 32. And now I can solve for x. And that's going to be the answer. And again, I put in 68 because it's what the question asked me to put in. So to start this, I would like to get the x by itself. Let me get rid of the 32 with it on the right-hand side, and I can do that by subtracting 32 on both sides, both the left and the right. Now, on the left, 68 minus 32 will be positive 36 equals 1.8x, and the positive 32 and negative 32 I had on the right cancel with each other. Now I want x equals, not 1.8x equals, so I'll divide out the 1.8 in front of the x. So 36 divided by 1.8 equals 1.8x over 1.8, and x equals 36 over 1.8 can be written as 36 divided by 1.8, and you can run that through your calculator. And when you do, you'll see that the answer is 20. So that means that 68 degrees Fahrenheit is the equivalent temperature of 20 degrees Celsius.